I'm going to show you how to create an asymmetrical effect on a mountain and then use that for texturing purposes. So we will start off by creating a ridge node, and let's play with the seed a little bit so we can get a very clear mountain range. There it is. That looks pretty cool. And I'm going to increase the height so that we get a bit more area down here to play with. Now, on top of this, I'm going to apply erosion. I'm going to increase the duration and the coarse sediments so we can get these nice flows. I think I'm going to increase the sediments even more just to make these flows stronger. And I'm going to reduce the coarse angle just so it brings down these sediments even further. So that's looking good. Now, what I want to do is I want to leave this side of the ridge alone, but I want to create some effects on this side. So what I'll do is I'll first create a stratified node, which is creating this effect. And then next, I don't think I'm going to change this too much, at least not yet. But what I want to do is apply it just to that one specific area. And so for that, let me go down here to the modifiers for the stratify node and add mask by height. This is now creating an instant height mask for this effect. And so let me bring that down lower and lower still. I'm going to reduce the fall off, but increase the distortion so the edges are a little bit distorted. And so here you can see there's not much going on the back or up here on the main ridgeline, but down here we have this stratified look. So the next thing I want to do is change the stratification a little bit. So right now we have a very high spacing. I want to reduce that just so we can get more detail out here. And I'm going to leave the fall off to be very low because I don't want like smooth blending. I like how this is looking like it's, you know, jutting out from the main landscape. So let's say this is pretty much what we want for our terrain. So now I want to texture this. And so to do that, first I'm going to create a texture base. And I'm going to have a very high slope and a little higher value for soil. And then to that, I add a sat map. And so I want to create two different color maps, one that's going to be for all of the terrain, and then one that's just for the exposed strata. So to do that, first, let me create something. Oh, that looked nice. That's simple enough. And let me make another one. And this one will make it slightly different so that it shows that we have that exposed strata, which should look like there's some minerals or whatnot coming out. So I want to find a color map that can do it justice. Maybe something like this, because it will go hand in hand with this. And then we can adjust it later. So first thing I want to do, I want to select both of these, right click, and combine into mixer as color layers. So I now have these two color layers. Now, this one is being distributed by height, but I just want it very specifically to go where this effect is. And so to do that, I'm going to create a data extractor node. The data extractor node will then plug into Stratify. And since it's set to modifier mask by default, it will look at where that effect is being applied and extract that exact mask. So we now have this ready, which I can then plug into mask one for layer one, and then go to layer one, and instead of height, I will switch it to custom. So here you can see it's being applied right here. What I'll do is I will right-click and lock preview to the mixer output, go to this other sat map, and maybe change it a little bit, play around with it. Oh, maybe that's too much. I can also equalize to get more mileage out of that masked area. This is looking good. And to now cement this look, because it still looks like it's separate, I'm going to unlock the preview. From here, I'm going to create color erosion. and color erosion, the height will go all the way back to our strata because it needs a height input. And so here I'll increase the sediment density a little bit, reduce the color hold, but increase the flow volume, maybe a little bit more blend and transport distance. And you can see it's starting to seep in. I think maybe what I would like to have is a bit more texture on the rest of the terrain. So go back here and maybe equalize this one as well. And then use the bias to bring in some color way up here. Going back, that's our mixer. You can see this fits more nicely. And then now when we blend them, they blend together well. So this is a great example of how you can quickly create masked area effects and use them however you like.